Team yellow is the
red side. And then team white is on the blue side. Couple of notable people in this lobby. Couple of returning customers here at the solo queue tournament atmosphere.
Yeah.
Gonna be interesting to see who's got the skills to progress past this stage. I think both of their lives are on the line. So we will see who takes this game. Now, Fizz and Ezreal already taken off the table.
Ezreal surprises me.
As soon as the caster cam goes off, we just fall.
Yeah, we're both just like, all right, it's all right. They're not looking at us. We can just chill now. For all you guys know, we just took off all our clothes.
Yeah.
Only the people at that's
at
inappropriate.
The venue. Only people at the
Fizz and Echo Band. This is just an Ezreal band. I don't understand the Ezreal band.
Could be just targeted. There's
I mean,
the
yeah,
spell
but
cause targeted.
Ezreal is still, like, even if you're really good at Ezreal, he's so slow to actually get going.
It's true.
That you can play a perfect Ezreal at level
you can
6 and, like,
on
do whatever,
it.
But
yeah.
You wouldn't actually benefit hugely from it. Whereas Vel'Koz is slightly more utility based. It's also ridiculous amounts of damage to spew out. So,
by the way,
is Echo Lux, somebody tells me they're targeting.
Kled!
Oh boy!
Oh boy, hot diggity damn! Wow. I love me some Kled!
I was not anticipating Kled to be played this time.
It's all Kled, guys. It's all Kled.
Kled's got a really weird kit. So.
You know what?
I'm not even sure.
I don't even know what
that I'm fully familiar with Kled's kit.
Johnny Tsunami in the chat, go Team Yellow. Where
this
is
a
the
bite.
White?
This is,
where
yeah,
is the white?
No
where is the white love? That's not very racist, but where is the Team
where
White
is
love?
Love?
Where is the love for Team White, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah, White just locked in play.
That is
I don't like the way
call.
That I said that. It's not very.
Well, the champion just
White
came
up. White just locked in
play. The guy just came
out.
Skill cap is unknown. This champion.
I think the skill cap is relatively high, just from what little I've seen.
We've got Silver. Sorry, that's the name of the person playing Rek'Sai. We got Rek'Sai and Sivir being locked in. Really good chase so far. We're seeing here really good chase potential. There's more Team Yellow hype,
And a lot of objective control with the Rek'Sai. Well, Rek'Sai level 3 gank is, like, rarely anticipated, but frequently frequently successful.
I'm gonna go on
kind of the whole point.
On a little bit of a tangent here.
Do it.
When Twitter first started up, people claimed some of the most unusual tags. Yesterday I found @John. That's, like, can you, like, that is so much power. League of Legends, a name like Silver was hard to get.
I mean,
logistically speaking, if I were to get the account name David, you know how hard that would be. This
I know the guy personally who has the account name.
Wow. You see what I mean? Like
yeah.
Getting that name is like, wow, that's Cody. Oh, dude.
But that's the thing, is that he found the guy who had. Actually, no, that was that's Sky. Sky found the guy who had Sky asking for it. Cody literally was just like, I'm just going to try it. It's not going to be available, but I'm going to try it. And he tried it, and it was there. And he just got it. So I've been trying to write down the James. I don't care about the player. I just care about the
game. You have Akron and Sona. Sona's going to be interesting. Is she still a late game powerhouse to use it?
No, Sona, I mean, she got hotfixed, and she got hotfixed and left her.
There we go, Team White, let's go, baby, let's go. There's a huge delay, so that's going to be a very, very delay, but thank you. You are very quiet compared to the music, I know why. I didn't turn off this audio. Sh-
should be all good now. Should be all good now. We do see Corki and Zillion being hovered.
This is I love this score. I
love Corki as a champion, but I'm gonna be honest, he's not very good. He's just like not very good in the current state of the meta. Xerath being the last pick here.
I like the brand. I like the brand.
Brand is
a
lot of
third in Janna.
See what last, I think the top is what's left for Team Yellow.
Zillion, I love me some Zillion.
But I also love me some Brand. I really do.
Yeah?
Brand does a lot of damage, and especially if these guys...
Brand does do a lot of teamfight damage. This is a very, you know, you put a shield on Sivir, she ricochets everybody. Rek'Sai flashes in, knocks them all up, and then Brand ults them. Whereas on the blue side, you got a much...
Fiora.
Fiora.
This was a
to match up against Zed. She longs for
Wizards. She longs for Wizards. Well, let's see if Kled will be able to stand up against Fiora. This is going to be an interesting matchup. This is like, this is, you know what? We should feel special. As casters, this is like a first. Like, even the casters over there, the H2K Splice game, they haven't even casted Kled yet. This is a privilege, man.
Which, by the way, Splice has a 8K gold lead around 36 minutes.
This is what I think about LCS right now. This all games go 1-1. It's always like the next game, the other team wins. It's very rarely a 3-0 anymore or like a 3-1.
That's because teams are just getting better at adapting to series. Hopefully, we'll see that in the later rounds, in the bracket rounds.
Nevertheless,
bracket
like
stages.
I was saying, this is a casting first. Has anyone casted Kled? Probably not. This is going to be spicy.
True.
This is going to be spicy. This is here at Esports Canada TV, a special first. Now, we're going to have to change. Don't stand up. It's okay.
We're just going to relax.
We're just going to relax.
I'll sit up a little bit.
We'll sit up a little bit, but we're just going to chill.
Sit back, relax. How you doing, Simo?
Oh. I'm doing great. There's pizza in my belly. I've got two slices of pepperoni. And I've got
a couple of slices of disgusting.
Two Hawaiian.
Hawaiian.
This guy is allergic to pineapple. So he's
also it's a vial. So
he's excused from hating the pineapple pizza. But if you don't like pineapple on pizza... I really feel sorry for you. I feel like you need to get your life together.
You know what
college,
I feel sorry for?
Get an education. What?
I feel sorry for this low mobility mid in Brand having to deal with Hecarim ganks.
It's true. Wow. Didn't notice that.
Hecarim has been banned in the previous two games. Because I got them all written down on this here piece of paper.
Team White all-in comp. Team Yellow AoE comp. Well, Team White's definitely got an all-in comp.
I mean, Team White's more of a pick comp than anything. If you want, like, if you think about like with the Zillions and the Sonas and the
I think that's what they mean by all-in. Like, once they catch the pick, like, they're not retreating, they're not going back.
I mean, yeah, because Kled's literally is his whole kit is based around. Just kind of going forward real fast.
Yeah.
Like, with the Kled initiate kind of thing. Like, Kled's the kind of champion that you don't retreat on. You can't retreat on Kled.
You got to make a clear call.
His
now,
whole kit is infinitely stronger if you're just like, all right, I'm just going to heck you up.
What I do got to say is I feel like this both teams here have literally, like, what, like some of the most random picks. Like, I don't think there was a whole lot, like... You know, correct me if I'm wrong. You know, these guys will probably approach me after, you know, the stream and be like, guys, like, you guys, you know, don't know what we're thinking. But I don't know if a lot of thought went into some of these picks. Maybe on White's side with the Kled and the Hecarim, like, that's, like, a very good combination. Like, Hecarim scales with movement speed.
Mm-hmm.
He presses E. Kled presses ultimate. Look at that.
That combo
plus
the Sona speed. Plus the Sona speed plus the Zillion speed.
That's really good.
That actually must be.
That's actually really good.
And the Zillion ulti. That I'm sure.
But looking at Team Yellow, I'm not really sure what's going on. And maybe you might have some insight on that. Maybe you've got some street knowledge. Maybe you got what it takes. What does it take? What has Yellow got?
I mean, Yellow has an amazing split pusher and dueler in Fiora, and they've got a really good
even if, like, they have a really good comp for a even shorthanded team fight with the brand and with the Sivir. Just a boatloads of AoE damage area.
That's true. Brand, Sivir, right? That's true.
Damage.
It's true. But I did say I wanted to see a Kled today.
You did say that. You also said that you wanted it to be mid played by Zot of Team Sapphire.
Or Wrath played top.
Well, this player is neither Zot nor Wrath.
It's true.
The Zot nor Rat. However, it is Unknown Panther.
Let's see. Who's got the mastery? Pause, right? Discord problems. It's always the worst kind of problems.
There it is.
We are going to switch over to the beautiful game screen so you fine ladies and germs can see what's going on. They are unpausing the game, and for some reason...
it is.
Oh, I know exactly why there's no audio. Because I turned it off while I was playing. Wait, what? I didn't press OK. That's awkward. All right. That is the slowest vote.
It at 0.5 speed, buddy.
Oh, this has been a rocky start, but nevertheless, boy, we're up to speed.
Also, sorry, real quick, just gonna turn this down a little bit.
Just a smidgen.
Just a smidge.
Let's start every cast. I mean, we did it a little bit in a previous one, but lane to watch.
I want to keep my eye on this top lane because I want to see what Kled's dueling potential is like against someone who's obviously an excellent dueler in Fiora, considering her whole title is the Grand Duelist.
It's true.
Le Grand Duelist.
The Grand Duelist.
I speak French, I swear. I also want to see where this Hecarim or the way the way this jungle matchup turns, because it's very both of these. Both of these junglers, rather, have a lot of potential to get an early gank off to help to snowball their lanes. Whether they're going to try and do that in the mid lane with the Zillion versus Brand to keep the Brand down or to keep the Zillion from getting his Rod of Ages in time, assuming that is indeed the build he plans on.
One thing that you need to... Oh, this is really spicy. Hecarim doesn't know that
he doesn't know they're there.
He's not going to be able to get the red buff in time. We got to keep our eyes on this huge start or this ball lane to get the early aggression. But Cap Chocobo turns it around. Rek'Sai's going to see this happen. Oh, this is awkward. Oh, he smites it for some HP. Is he going to juke it? What's going on?
Spam.
Oh, the reset. Oh, he pops Ghost. I'm not sure what's going on, but they're going to try to collapse. Zillion? And who else is that chasing back? There's Kled there as well.
And everybody gets out scot-free. Except
that is interesting.
Rek'Sai has level 2, has a full camp, and Hecarim is immediately behind him. Now, this is just lack of knowledge of the opposing champion. Rek'Sai will never start on the blue side because he doesn't want blue buff. He wants that red buff to go for that early gank. Not necessarily will never go for the red side, but he very rarely will start on the blue side. Because you don't need blue buff on Rek'Sai. Ideally, you hand that off. You hand off the first blue buff on level 4 to your mid lane and give them the ability to perma push.
It's going to be interesting to see.
A weak start. Definitely a weak start from this Hecarim. Who, as we can see, is only level 2.
He's gonna
and
need
is
power
almost
for him.
Dead.
This is an opportunity for Rek'Sai to make some plays, and as you can see, he's getting that scuttle, but he's probably gonna go. What he should do is go into Hecarim's jungle. He's still at base, he hasn't done either buff, but I think Rek'Sai is gonna gank instead. Considering
Rek'Sai got the scuttle bottom, or it's got a scuttle top lane, it's gonna be great.
Look at that damage. Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
That is insane. Oh,
blowing the flash. They can pick up.
Yeah, Kled down. Oh, but the turnaround really close. Really close. The first turret shot. I thought you would have died, really, but did a little less damage than I presumed. Hecarim is gonna fall behind it. Why is he going for blue buff? This is ridiculous.
Oh, going for another enable. He saw Rek'Sai topside, so actually it's not bad. He saw Rek'Sai topside, but Rek'Sai is responding with a steal of his own.
Interesting.
Very interesting. So not a bad move on behalf of Hecarim. And a nice response from Rek'Sai.
I'm worried that we're not going to see the full dueling potential of Kled with the boost that Fiora is going to get. And I feel like Rek'Sai is going to make multiple return appearances in the top lane, considering they're a duo. They signed up as a duo. So I feel like top lane is going to get a lot of love.
Silver and Marker are a duo, you think?
Yes.
Ah, I did not know that.
I love Corki's name. Sometimes you take time to just you take some time to, you know, Kled with the fancy footwork. I secretly want, I know that we shouldn't have biased casters, but see, look at this. Jesus. Kled is in a lot of trouble. He's still doing tons of damage onto Silver.
I mean, yeah, but he's pushed up so far and he doesn't have any vision anywhere.
He definitely needs to play it a little bit safer, considering now Marker, aka Young Fiora,
has a huge lead.
Has a huge lead. Two kills, Corrupting Potion intact. Anytime Kled wants to duel now, he's going to need to think twice. Maybe even think thrice.
Thrice, you say?
Thrice.
Thrice, he says. Wow.
Now, this bot lane has been going fairly steady, but Sona does not have the same potential as Janna in the early stages of the game. It's a little bit of a lead as Sivir's pushing in Corki, but that's understandable. Sivir's a pushing champion.
Impressed with the Zilean, to be honest. I love Zilean as a champion. I think Zilean is so much fun. He's hilarious. And it's just wonderful on all ends.
I actually still think Kled can duel. Actually, no, he can't. I lied. Oh, the Renekton tango there.
A little bit.
He's about to lose his pet.
Snarl is good.
Look at that damage, though.
There it is. There's the Hecarim gang.
Oh, the... Ooh. Wow!
Really well played.
That was amazing. And he with
Flash
the...
in the mask.
Oh, baby.
That's something we don't get in LCS.
Oh, I'm sitting up for this one. This is what in Dead by Daylight we call the snuggle basement. It's the snuggle basement.
Why?
When things are getting heated.
I feel like Dead by Daylight is the worst game to have something called the snuggle basement. Rek'Sai's coming.
Oh, here we go. Silver.
Corki with the Valak will stay safe.
The snuggle basement is pretty much a place where the killer can take you. And there's like hooks that cannot be destroyed. So that's why it's called the snuggle basement. Because you're dead. The snuggle basement. Nevertheless,
snuggling with that
killer.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, to snuggling to your dude. Now we do see Hecarim is just invading this entire game. He's just taking camp by camp by camp. You could, like, I bet his favorite pastime is to go camping with his family, because this guy is going camp to camp, making sure Rek'Sai does not get food on the table. And look, he's caught up. Caught up in CS because he's taken Rek'Sai's farm.
Yeah, like,
Rek'Sai's got nothing
very
to go back to.
Considering how horrible the early game went for Hecarim, with that honestly just like completely nonsensical and ridiculous invade that he made in the early game without even checking to see if Rek'Sai was on that side. Doing all right for
that himself. That is a classic solo queue play. He's playing this like a solo queue tournament, and
exactly.
I respect that. I highly respect that. He even has a pink ward on their blue. Like, this guy, he knows how to make things happen.
And I like that a lot, actually. I really like when you don't get deterred from making aggressive plays just because you happen to mess one up early. But they're calculated plays, right? You know, making that play in the top lane.
I think Hecarim is going to make a return appearance, but both alleyways are warded. Might change his options. Go to that mid lane. Where's the Valkyrie going?
Package.
Oh, Flash comes out. There's the stun. There's the ulti. Bouncer-oo. Babadoo. But no one's going to die to that one. There's Hecarim. The ulti preemptively used by Zillion.
Corki Flash. Brand Flash.
Oh.
Zillion ulti.
He wants it. There's the ulti comes out. There's Hecarim, but they decide to change their mind. Kled. That's the back up, back away. Porky's missing out on a lot of CS. I don't think he should have ganked that mid lane. I don't think that was like a was a good idea. Now Sona's stuck.
I mean, I like the idea behind it. It's just poor execution.
But they got
the kill. And they're about to lose first brick gold. Team's turret has been destroyed. Goes over to Sivir.
Blue buff going over to Hecarim. Finds Rek'Sai potentially. So far, this is wow, flash from Sona. There's the damage onto Janna. She flashes out. Monsoon coming out, but will the rockets connect? The movement speed slow. Oh boy, Fiora's making her way downtown to that bot lane. Flashes in onto the Sona. There's the slow, and Captain Chocobo picks up the mother fragger. What's his name?
Yeah, that's his name.
Mother fragger. And they get the, is that Cloud Drake?
That is Cloud Drake. Indeed.
Corki going for the steal. I don't think he's going to steal.
Quick update for those wanting to be prepared. The EU LCS semifinals. Splice just won the game to tie the series. Okay.
It's now a best of three. Oh, I want to see this Kled like up and running. I want to see him pop off. He's building what, Black Cleaver first?
I am expecting so. Yeah. Based on the fact that he's got the build and such.
Corki's trying to do his best to catch up. Once he gets Trinity Force, Corki
leaving lane against the Sivir is so risky, especially as Corki just doesn't play nearly as fast. Sivir has such a good way clear. Rek'Sai with the BM. Wow, they're really strong at this game. They say in champions, like, everybody pick the champion that you have the highest mastery on. And we're just gonna spam. Oh.
Interesting. There's already a 3k gold lead on Team Yellow. How did that happen? What?
First brick.
Okay, let's see. Kled down by 1.1k.
Corki down by 1.2k.
And that pretty much adds up to 3k. Pulse is very relatively close.
Yeah, and the support lead for Janna is about 600.
Wow. Talisman of Ascension OP confirmed.
I mean, also an assist helps.
It's true.
As well as getting part of the first break.
Kled's gonna bite off a little more than he can chew, potentially. Rek'Sai's waiting in the wings. Oh, he's gonna need to make a run for it.
And he's out.
Ooh,
I'm just gonna take a tower shot if I can.
That's good. Another Valkyrie is available for Corki, but he probably won't use that until another fight breaks out. Kled doing the tango, which jukes out the riposte. And here comes Hecarim. But I'm not sure what happened there. I think he ran over a minion. The knockback didn't go through onto
I think he was trying to bait the Fiora riposte. Waited a little bit. The idea is there, for sure.
It's just constant hits. Ooh, turn your attention.
There's one thing that is like extraordinarily satisfying is landing a good spell shield on Sivir. They launch their highest damage ability, and you just like press B and then, oh, back off!
It's true.
Nothing
happened. Nice, that was a great impression.
So one thing I did find about a Kled, that Kled without his mount, that Garl, that weird dinosaur thing that he runs around on, has the lowest move speed, or the lowest base move speed in the game.
Yikes.
So once that mount gets popped and that those iframes dissipate,
That's why the mount is the most important part of the head.
And playing around that dismount.
He can't even ult without his mount, I assume.
Ooh, Rift Herald's going.
They're just sealing the deal in this top lane.
I mean, yeah, it's already
Fiora's got
CS advantage, and now she's got the Rift Herald. Just even more to add to her already ridiculous. Zillion's already on Rod of Ages, which is very nice. Where Brand isn't on. Zillion's already got full stack on his Rod of Ages, where Brand just has the components. So Zillion is scaling up faster and providing much more of an impact in these team fights, especially with the speed and the revive on this Hecarim, who is out farming the Rek'Sai, despite the fact that the Rek'Sai did go that typical Rek'Sai build as a flame weapon.
I wonder. I think once we start team fighting, Team White is gonna look a lot stronger. Right now, they look like their backs are against the wall, and it's true. Fiora's incredibly strong. Sivir's pushing down the bot. Then
they're waiting for their power spikes. Zillion's hit one. Corki is very close. But there is a huge discrepancy between the power of the three components, having the three components of Trinity Force, and then actually combining them into the Trinity Force. So once Corki manages to get that combine, there is a package available in base for him. So I'll recall that gets him. Well, Lissy died right now. Use your flash, friend.
Oh.
Here's a little tip for those aspiring League of Legends masters. Always flash before you get CC. Because if you get CC, you're probably going to have to flash anyway, and you might die. You might have to flash.
Put an axe in your brain!
This is dangerous.
Unknown Panther loses. Hope he actually goes on to Silver. Silver's over there as well. Oh, that's Corki. Why did he go in on that? Hecarim and Zillion are in a little bit of trouble. There's a lot going on.
And that was a disaster for White. And absolutely used all. They used a late power spike on Corki with the 34th package instead of trying to, like, you know, bring up the midnight bomb. Instead of trying to impact the teamfight mid where he could have gotten 3 or 4 kills, it helped his team actually impact the map. It was kind of caught and died. And even if he didn't die, he would have gotten that best job. And then Garl would die after. 3 internal break.
So Brand has 1 stack on Rod, Zillion has 5. So that's already like a huge discrepancy. That's 50 AP. Isn't it 10 every 1 stack?
Yeah, so it's 40 AP.
But he's at 5.
Yeah, but Brand's at 1.
Well, now he's
2
at
now.
6. Yeah.
Like 4 stacks.
Oh my goodness. Oh, that's actually a really good ult. Oh my goodness, mother fragger. Woo. Oh, but here comes Rek'Sai. Way to ruin the party, Silver. But there's the squad. Hecarim and Zillion are there to boot. He's going in. Valkyrie's in. Go studied. Takes down Janna. The TP comes out from Fiora.
Nice response to a otherwise somewhat disastrous. dragon. Picking up a couple kills. Zillion is going to start doing a lot of damage.
Yeah, I was just thinking that. I was thinking Zillion is going to be the saving grace of this team. I apologize, ladies and germs. You aren't missing too much. Not much action. As during that.
Fiddle.
Yeah. I'm a fiddler, dude. I'm a big fiddler. We have to note as well, Yora still has Rift Herald.
Oh, it's a 20-hit plus.
Yeah.
She's going to have Rift Herald until about 35 minutes.
We need to keep an eye on that, because she's going to be doing a lot. She needs to do a lot with it.
Yeah, she needs to be super. You know, ideally, she'd be put in the bottom lane. I mean, both top towers are already taken for Yellow. So if you put Kajura in the bottom lane and then start sieging in the mid lane, the only real wave clear that they have is really working in slow wave clear. Considering how much faster you can push with the Sivir and the Brand.
Wow.
That's the Trinity Force spike. Trinity Force.
Well, he's
BF
got
BF sword.
Sword too, so that's a lot of damage.
That was a very quick chunk.
I think White needs one more team fight, a couple more picks to catch up to Yellow, in my opinion. That's not the way to do it.
Yeah.
What a valiant effort.
Yura's got 2 points. But she shouldn't be grouping with her team. This is making the Rift Herald buff completely useless. Like, it doesn't do anything if you're close to an ally. The whole point is her Rift Herald is to. She needs to be going bottom.
I always hate this A-Ram. Both teams like stand in the middle of
yeah,
the
I'm a mid laner. Think about how I feel about it. You're just like sitting there,
taking
all my farm.
Hecarim's taking a little bit of damage.
Well, it looks like it's just a little bit of a poke back and forth. Sona's trying to deal with that ward. Good shoot for Marker. Marker's still looking for something.
Oh, looks like he can go in on it. Stun comes out of Torque. Valkyrie's away. TP's coming into the play. Will he pop his ultimate?
Not yet.
It's definitely a part of the fight. It's definitely some. Oh, almost had the pull there. Oh, there's the stun on the Captain Choke. Well, that's amazing. Motherfucker takes that. Yora in the back line getting Hecarim there. Oh, what's happened here? Yora's looking for something. The Zillion is dangerously low. He does have ult available. Porky's out to the side, poking through, but Silver's looking for the knockup. Valkyrie's away. Has to use his package.
I mean, better than he does. I see a lot of Corkies.
They're looking
for the turrets.
Oh, here's Glad. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Marker's taking way too much damage. He studies it. Oh, what do you mean he studies it? He flashes it, shut down, going over. There's Glad, my big boy on campus. He's looking for something, but Yummy Spirit stuns him in his tracks. But there's the Zillion. There's the connect with the hook. And Silver's trying to turn it around. Corki gets snapped, dropped, and killed by the Rek'Sai. And Kled picks that one up. Let's go, baby. I'm looking for some Kled action tonight. There's hot Kled singles in your area, because that's what I'm looking for.
Wow, that was very impressive. I love the sound that plays. Great.
And can you imagine with different skins? Could be like different skins?
Yeah, like, you should have a Katy Perry clan that just plays
Dark Horse.
Not
Dark
Miley Cyrus's clan.
I think what would be really good is
in like a regular.
There's the medieval skin right now, right?
Yeah.
It'd be sick if it was a trumpet. And he like rolls up.
It might be. I can see that. Hecarim is tower in the bottom lane. And other towers, there is a Cloud Drake available, which is really good for Hecarim.
I think they're definitely thinking about it. Corki's got it. Corki's doing stuff. Corki's finally doing stuff.
Yes.
I'm really happy for him.
He gets the essence.
are working on this Cloud Drake. They've got it below half. White's back in this. They've definitely started to find their footing.
Yellow has successfully thrown the game.
But, no, they haven't. Fiora split.
They have.
The reason why Yellow...
They had a huge lead.
They did, but there's still a 2K lead. White's still not back. But the reason why Yellow is playing with the back throw right now is because they have to force Fiora to flip push. They have to get Kled out. And then once Kled goes to clean up the wave, that's when Fiora, you see she's in the middle of a rotation. She's looking for a pick. They still have the turret. There's still a lot of wave clear from White. So I don't think Yellow's going to break this barrier. They're not going to break this hold. And let's even talk about this for the fact of the matter. White still has that mid lane tower. That's what's stopping Yellow from advancing. That's why they're pushing so hard down this mid lane, because White has all of three towers on the outer edge. They're able to kind of push back and he was pushed further, whereas Yellow's like, hey guys, you need this middle tower.
And you need this middle tower. That's what helps you open up the map. Moving your vision line deeper and deeper into the enemy jungle is so hard to do when the enemy team has that protection of that middle tower. Poke fight, jungle, worst case scenario, oh no, back up a little bit, back up behind your tower, wait for you. Nothing.
Honestly, hearing that Kled ult when Corki was fighting, I was like, oh baby, it's happening, I was ready. Now Corki's in a little bit of trouble, has to Valkyrie away. Sivir showing him how it's done with a couple of boomerangs. Just telling him. Rockets don't do a whole lot. And it's so satisfying to see double Zillion Bomb just kill a minion wave.
Yeah, the Zillion. As well as the Corki who just hit. Actually, there's...
No way.
There's three...
No.
No,
they're
just gonna hit right.
Yeah. If there was no vision, I can guarantee you they would have done it. If there was no ward, they probably would have wanted to do it.
That's something that...
Yeah.
Would do?
You know, I think Hot is a hot. Would definitely do that.
I mean, he did just reach.
He
a
did
huge
have
power spike.
He did have the mother fragger with him, which would have provided the dank heals.
There are huge. Oh my god, this is a Lich Bane Sona. Okay. Interesting. I'm sure
you'll never
team,
expect.
I'm sure her team will probably prefer.
You never
building last support.
You'll never expect that power.
No, you're
not expecting that power play.
Until it hits you for all of your HP, and then you're like, wait a minute. Oh,
yeah.
Sona's building AP.
You need to keep an eye on Fiora, but
you noticed after you've been chunked by something.
Kled is actually doing a good job of rotating back and forth. I'll give him that. Wow, he caught her. Wow, that was amazing. Here comes Hecarim for the backup. He knocks Mark away, but she's gonna turn her attention to Kled. Actually takes him down. There's the fear. Mark is gonna actually be able to fuel this, but I think Hecarim's got this. Almost falling low.
Very close.
That was very close. But wow, I do have to say that without Fiora, Yellow might be useless. I mean, they do have Brand. I'll give him that.
And
they do have Shiver. But they still have this. Like, I don't. I feel like they have all their confidence in Fiora. That's the problem. Go study. Gets the ultimate. He's able to revive. Sona does die. But here comes Hecra, baby. Let's go. Gets blown up by Silver. But Bullseye.
Get a return kill.
Gets a return kill.
Get a return kill on Silver.
What was that noise?
I think that was a... I mean, it must be a Kled.
I think it's Brand. Oh,
there
baby.
He comes.
Here we go, boys. Oh, my God. This Kled is amazing. Oh, my God. Did you see that? He, like, killed the... what a beast. Oh, my goodness.
Press R.
Oh, man. I don't care what he pressed. He did something
play.
Cool.
Spectacular play.
Play of the game right there. He played.
I know where his moves go.
That was amazing. That was Kled-tacular. That was Kled-tastic.
Yeah.
Noah, he took us to a trip to Kledtopia, man. He was definitely the Kled mayor of that town.
Kled mayor.
Who's the Kledsident? No, that one didn't.
Give you a solid.
He was the prime, Kledister.
You gotta stop.
I'm just. I have Kled mania, man. I can't stop. Won't stop. Kledomania. Every time he's got his ult up, I'm ready.
I just love the sound. The sound is so hypey.
Take me away, Kled. Take me away. Take me to. Nevertheless, 3K gold lead now on Team Yellow. Putting in that Fiora's definitely putting in some work. Sivir's got a gold lead on Young Cork.
I'm triggered by this one.
Oh, baby, they want it. Are they going to get it? She's making a run for it. She makes the flash, but there's the fear. Actually misses. There's the stun by Sivir. Oh, Hecarim's falling a little bit dangerous. Ultimate comes out, but there's the Valkyrie, baby. Oh, no. They bit up a little bit more than they can shoot. Kled making a little bit late to the party, but Hecarim is still alive. Double kill going over to Bram, baby. Let's go. Triple. Will he get the quadra? He won't be able to make it there in time, but Kled taken down by Captain Chocobo and Yellow cleaning up shop, open up a brand new store, getting a dragon to boot. Wow.
Don't package Valkyrie into five people so that you can 2v5. In my opinion, that's wrong.
You know, I'm just a caster, you know. Yeah. I might not know much.
But I know what I do know. I know enough. That was a very poor decision on behalf of the
I think it's about time that he does some study.
It's time to go study.
You know, that NA scouting thing, that might not be for you, Cork.
But that brand built in that was actually
amazing. Spectacular work from the Young Spirits.
Absolutely. So much. All the like AoE slow and everything. A lot of bases really stacked up, and Rylai's got the voice staff up. All he needs is a pink ward.
You know what, Crippin? You know what?
Consolation prize.
Never rule out the Kled. Never. Ever. Disrespect the Kled. Nobody ever disrespects the Kled. I don't even disrespect the Kled.
Hey, what's the name of his? First ability. His Q ability called
Bear Trap
on a rope.
But I got it though.
Yeah,
so did. Don't even say I don't know about Kled, because I know a lot about Kled. Kled is my new main. Only got champion one mastery on it, but that's fine. Like, that's more than enough to
You get champion one mastery for losing a game.
Hush. I got Kled mania, man. Can't be stopped.
Yeah, this is like when Bard came out, and Bard was like a very chunky champion.
Kled is not weak. Kled champion. Is not chunky. He's
no,
got,
not chunky. Junky.
You know what?
Very hyped up though.
Kled and Peck. After the Baron comes down, we need to find a Kled. If I'm being real with you. Corki, no! Captain Chocobo on a killing spree. Hecarim's going balls to the wall, but Yummy Spirits can't be stopped. Double kill going over to Chocobo. Fiora cleaning up shop.
And the emote spam. What the actual hell was Corki doing? You just Valkyried into five people again. Only this time, they had Baron buff.
I think it's time to go study. It might
what
be time
What the
to
hell?
Go study.
I'm tilted. I'm so triggered by that.
Oh, what a beautiful Sona, ladies and gentlemen. She's got the Lich Bane. She's going in. She's gonna
the
stop
Sona
him. She's gonna stop
up.
Him. No way.
Let's go.
Rest in peace.
I'm triggered.
Rest in peace.
I am so triggered.
Rest in peace.
Holy moly.
Corki MVP of the game.
Disagree.
Corki MVP. Corki is my hero.
For Valkyrieing into a 2v5 situation Corki, twice in a row.
Let's take a look killing. At this kid's damage, okay? This kid's damage is probably going to be through the roof. All right there, Scooter. Look at this guy. 17K. What a champ, kid. This guy.
I mean, but he single-handedly lost this game.
You know what? You know what, Corki? Meet me in the lobby. I'll give you a participatory award. It's just, you know, thanks for trying.
For Look at the clutch damage. Look at the clutch damage. You did less than 7,500 damage.
He was up against the Lich Bane Sona. Like, how do you expect the man to out-damage Lich Bane Sona? Like,
He was on the same team as the Lich Bane Sona. Yeah, but and he did out-damage the Lich Bane Sona.
And that's why I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen, Kled is the best champion to ever be released since League of Legends' birth.
Okay.
Kled is a god amongst men. You know, like, let's not even talk about Fiora's damage sitting at 30k. Let's forget that Sivir.
Yeah, forget about
the
amazing brand ulti that literally won them the game in the bottom lane.
The brand who has set a standard for solo queue hero. Let's just focus on Kled. Kled is the man.
Kled was definitely in that game. For sure.
He held his fist up high and he said, fight the power. And the power eventually beat him. But nevertheless, he stood up for what he believed in.
Honorable mention, the Zillion deserves some praise because you did played very well. Never saw you use your barrier, I'll be honest. And the ults were a little bit off, but apart from that, played very well. Position was very good. Your firing was good. Your potential for the playmaking was very good.
You know what, Zillion?
Unfortunately.
Bullseye.
You'll have
Bullseye
to
performance, Zillion. Bullseye performance. You hit it right the nail head. It was there.
You get a compensation medal. We are going to take
a
hot break. Coming up next, the bracket stages. All right? All right?
Johnny Tuami. Okay. Meet me in the lobby, dude. Kled is the man. All right. Relax. We'll be back. Take care.
Bracket stages are next.